How's the gaming? I'm Phil the Blanks, and welcome back to Let's Play Donkey Kong Land 2 Into Web Woods. For some reason, the last episode, I thought we were going to be doing the boss right away, but no, we still have one level left. Totally forgot about this one. Probably because it's like one of my least favorite levels in the original Country 2, and that's because it's pretty much all Squidder, and I don't like Squidder even more in this version of the game just because of the weird press B to shoot a web, press select to set it. I just don't know why they just didn't make it press B again. But I've complained about this like three times this Let's Play. I should probably let it go at this point. Plus, it doesn't look like we're encountering Squidder anytime soon. My goodness, where are you, man? I don't remember how there he is. I don't remember how much of a thing he was in the Super NES version. I think it's most of the level. Surprised it went that far without it in this one. Yeah, it looks like I'm gonna have to. You gotta use him. Poor kid who didn't realize that pressing select would do something. Getting stuck there. That would really suck. So I think this is the only time you are absolutely required to use Squidder. So. But it's not too bad. You just take it slow. Despite the fact that your web starts blinking as soon as you set another web, it actually lasts a little bit longer than you'd think. So don't rush too much. That was my problem at the beginning of the game. I was rushing a lot. But that's okay. Squidder just has a really weird, like, center of, not gravity, but like where it counts as him standing on a platform is a little funky, because he's very wide. So, you gotta be really careful of where his center is, basically. There we go. And these aren't really super long gaps, too, which is nice. Whee! There we go. I know that there is kind of at least one part where we kind of need to say low in order to get a bonus room or a DK coin. I always forget which one. We're just going to stay down here a little bit. Okay, nothing right here. There's a lot of verticality, right? It's like two screens high. They can go up. There we go, DK coin. There we go. And then a sheer cliff right here. Careful. Oh, I mean, the arrow would have pointed me down anyways. That's pretty nice of them. Like, anyone with any sense of curiosity would have figured that out, I guess. That's good. Oof. A little closer, there we go. I do like the idea of Squidder. The spider using his powers like that. It's a neat animal buddy. I really do like the idea of it. Plus, it's always fun to have a projectile weapon in a platformer. Always is. It just makes it funner. I get all the... Oh, I just hit the NG. I have not been paying attention to the letters I've been getting, but I haven't really needed to at this point anymore. I don't think we'll have any problems with lives. We are doing just fantastic. Maybe in the last world a little bit, but... The difficulties seem to have plateaued a little bit. I found it went up really quickly at the beginning of the game, but it's really kind of just... not lessened, just the intensity hasn't been growing, so... I'm okay with that. It's a nice, comfortable difficulty at this point. Is that it? There we go. That went really, really smoothly. Fantastic. And now we get to fight Dead Bird Ghost Creepy Crow. And it's, like every other boss that we've fought so far, there is some slight changes over what it was in the Super NES version. It still is, you know, avoid vultures until you get a projectile. Just a little different, that's all. It's a shame. The only, boss that they actually took out, wow, that, like, almost went through. The only boss that we don't get is Clubba. I wonder why. I wonder if it is because he was just too big. I mean, I don't know. Crow's pretty big. Like, he's a pretty big sprite on the Game Boy, so I don't know why they did it. I don't know. Anyways, we jump up. Careful of the falling eggs. It always comes from the top. It doesn't go left to right like it does in some countries, so just be really careful. And then once we take him out here with a couple hits, we're done. Like, it doesn't go nearly as far as the Super NES version did, which is fine. If you're going to change anything for the Game Boy version, it makes sense that the bosses are going to be the thing that changes. Plus, you can't really tell that he's a ghost in this version, which is kind of a shame. In the country, if you haven't played it, Crow is the first boss in the first level. Are you dead? No, wow, just four hits. And after you beat him, he comes back in World 5 as a ghost, which is why he's Creepy Crow. So. And oh, hey, here's Club's Kiosk. I thought you had to beat the game. Scurvy Chimps Ahoy was trying cross without paying. We have 47 creme coins, but we only have 36. Yeah, I thought you had to beat the game, but you do need to beat the game and have everything to actually go in. So anyways, Arctic Abyss. Now we've got the kind of ice levels going into the castle levels. Hello, Amgard. I will gladly be you. You make water levels so much easier, my goodness. I was, just for reference in between episodes one day, I was like looking at the maps and some gameplay of Country 2. So it's just like, oh, are the levels in the same order, that kind of thing? Because we had kind of, I mentioned that with the Bramble Scramble, how it used to be in the Bayou level, and then it was in the... Anyways, I forgot how absolutely stunning Country 2 is for the Super Nintendo. Like, this still looks very good. I think it looks fine. But then it's like my mind is now, like, these are now the standard for how I see Dixie Kong because I've been playing this game. So when I think of, like, Dixie Kong, this is how I see her. Careful, DK. Oh, yeah. Oh, damn it. Whoops. At least we can go back and get that. No, I do not want to be you and Garg, because I want to jump out of the water. So I was looking, I was like, geez, I totally forgot how incredibly impressive Country 2 looks on the Super Nintendo, because this is just like how I view Donkey Kong now because I've been playing it. So, I don't know. Simply gorgeous game. 95, I think. 10 years old. That's crazy. I didn't know this before, but I guess when Nintendo announced Donkey Kong Country at, I believe it was CES, the Consumer Electronics Show, it's basically before E3 was a thing, and they showed off their little sizzle reel, damn it, and had Donkey Kong Country. And this is back when, like, the weird kind of mid-system war was happening with, like, the 32X and CD-based peripherals, and a lot of people were like, well, Nintendo's gonna get... careful. Nintendo's gonna get left behind because they still have the Super Nintendo, the Nintendo Ultra 64, as it was known back then, was delayed again. Like, no one knew when it was coming out, and people were like, well, if they don't have a peripheral or CD quality stuff, the Super NES isn't gonna cut it anymore. And they showed off Donkey Kong Country, and it was a big deal because it was just like, not on 32-bit, not on CD, only on Super Nintendo, and I guess people didn't believe it. Like people at CES were like, no, that's, like, straight up lying, what are you talking about? There's gotta be where's the hem coin here? Oh, there you are. There's gotta be some sort of peripheral you have to buy. It's like, no, it's in the cartridge. And it's funny because, oh jeez, I hate that drop it gives on guard there. It's crazy to think that while Country 1 looks spectacular, there were still two more Donkey Kong Country games that looked even better on the Super NES. It is also hard to believe that people were really impatient for the Nintendo 64, because it got delayed a couple times, and the PlayStation came out in Japan in 94, believe it or not. Let's see how we're doing. 71%, 1 hour and 39 minutes, nice. But yeah, the PlayStation was out in Japan already, and people were like, well, we need the N64. And it's... To me, the Super NES came out in 1991. And the PlayStation was 3 years later. That blows my mind how... Damn it. How small of a generation for video games that was. Because now we're so used to, like, the PlayStation 4 came out in 2013. And then it took until 2020 for the PS5. But, like... Back then, I can't imagine going from Super Nintendo to PlayStation 1 in only the span of 3 years. That's crazy. Anyways, we got Windy Well, I think it was called. Again, impressive that they're using the gimmick for Country 2 in this, with the whole, like, floating upwards, with the animations and everything. For some reason, not in this bonus round. That was a very basic bonus round. Shoot the barrels, Bentley Bear. Like, I know that. It's just weird. Okay, that was difficult. I'm glad that none of the bonus rounds are super difficult, because the fun is doing them, not having trouble. Oh, geez, that's like no room. Damn, wow, there's like no room on the platform, you damn rat. No, I guess we're back here. That's fine. We weren't super far in the level anyways. Yeah, look at that. There's a little animation for Diddy doing that, and Dixie has another one. I just think that's neat. They put a lot of genuine effort in this game. Like, for a quote-unquote port. I don't like calling it a port, because the levels are all completely different, but it's neat. There we go. Okay, so I can just jump on them. Oh god, there's another one. Friggin' no, gosh! That was... I don't like it. I don't like heights in real life, so I'm just imagining just falling and then all of a sudden wind picking me up. Actually, I guess that would feel amazing. I'd be like, oh, I'm flying. It's one of those things, like, I don't like heights in real life, but like, at the same time, the ability to fly, that'd be insane. Careful here, you kind of, like, the wind drops off there, so you gotta make your way below the zingers. And just like swimming and with Squawks when he's fluttering, holding up and down will cause you to go faster or slower. Again, crazy that they added all this in a Game Boy cartridge. Bravo. I really wish they could have done a Game Boy Color release. There were so many Game Boy games that really could have used a color release. I would have loved that. The Country games Land games absolutely should have been. Metroid 2 is planned to, and it's such a disappointment that it never happened. I still think, I say this every time we talk about Game Boy Color conversions, I can only think of two. This would be a DK coin over here. Oh, there it is. Jeez, okay. But I'm pretty sure the only two that I can think of anyways that got conversions, from Nintendo that is Warland 2. I'm pretty sure those came out roughly the same year though. And Link's Awakening, which was deserved. That was a great color port. Konami did a couple. I mean, both Castlevania Adventure, damn it, and Castlevania 2 Belmont's Revenge, both were redone in color. So was Nemesis. They had all like three full cartridges on the Game Boy Color that were like best of Game Boy games for like Konami's. Ah, damn it! I did not expect that. Konami's good at re-releasing like little collections. They are now. I mean, they don't actually make any good games anymore, but they're still very good at doing collections of things. Like the Castlevania was a Dominus collection, which is the 3DS games. I'm really happy that they did that. But yeah, even back then, like here's four of our classic Game Boy games, but now in color. I love that. That's really neat. It's a shame. I don't think they didn't have a license for it because it was Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. It would have been cool to see all three of the TMNT Game Boy games redone in color too. But still, the fact that they did like 12 of them is still really good. Better than Nintendo. They only did the two. I don't know if there's a difference between Warrior Land for Game Boy and Warrior Land for Game Boy Color. I only have the Game Boy Color version. I don't even think I've ever played the original regular Game Boy one. So I don't know if there's stuff that's not in the Game Boy one, but is in the Game Boy Color one. I'm not sure. Link's Awakening, they had the Game Boy Camera thing, which was very, very cool. I should play Game Boy Camera on this channel one day. They also did the Color Dungeon, which is very cool. I'm glad they kept that in the Link's Awakening for the Switch. That was neat. Onward and upward. Dungeon Danger. Now, it looks like Dungeon Dancer. this is one of those levels they had to take a little bit of a compromise with the, I think it was like, was it called Castle Crush maybe instead? But there used to be an elevator. It would go up and it would be like an auto-scroller, so they can't do that. I guess that was just too hard to implement, but they still had the castle levels. I think there's three castle levels in the game. And it's got that great music. Some of my favorite music from the original game. It's one of those, like, I know everyone loves Sticker Brush Symphony. And that just brings me all the way to, yeah, I gotta reclimb it, damn it. I know everyone loves Sticker Brush Symphony, rightfully so. It's one of the best soundtracks in gaming history, in my opinion. But man, the dungeon, like the castle music, is so good, and no one ever talks about it. But I really, really like it. So we'll talk about it now. David Wise, man, he was so good for the Donkey Kong Country games. Also, I learned that Grant Kirkhope is the one who transcribed these for the Game Boy. He did a great job. Grant Kirkhope, if you don't know him, he's like the other Rare musician guy, sound designer for Rare. He's the one who did the Donkey Kong 64 soundtrack and the Banjo-Kazooie soundtrack. I believe he also did Conker's Bad Fur Day, and he also did, I think it's him anyways, he did the, Mario and Rabbids games. And I guess he was like really hyped up about that because it's like, holy shit, I'm doing a Mario game. Like that was like a big deal. I'm like, that's kind of, I always like the idea of like these super, super, oh, I need a cannonball. Super famous, super, they're the top of their industry. And them still having like that, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm doing that. Like, it's just, it's kind of neat. It's cute to see like someone that talented be humbled, like humble about something. It's just nice. I don't know. I'm weird. There we go. Find the token. Let me guess. Is it? Yeah, the chains. Careful. Pretty simple. Oof, that's close. And easy. Wow. Yeah, the bonus levels are not getting harder at all. Which, again, I'm okay with. Definitely not, should not be too hard. Ooh, careful. Ooh, ho, 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 ho. See that? I'm a clever monkey. Or, what is Diddy again? I think he's a spider monkey. I think that's the official thing. I think he's not a chimpanzee. I think I called him a chimpanzee when I played these for the Super NES and someone corrected me. I think he's a spider monkey. I don't know. But DK is a gorilla, right? Like, there's not like a weird second version of that animal that he is that I just don't know about. I don't know. I don't think it really matters. Yay, go Diddy. I think that's both of the... Yes, it is, okay. But we are good for this level. We may leave. I think we're at the top anyways. Oh, jeez, that was really close to my face. Gosh, so many big jumps. Ooh, that's a big one. There we go, we're done. Fantastic, we have more. Time for one more to go, though. Clapper's Cavern. Oh, yes. This is another ice level. Clapper's back. And yes, thank you, Mike. The seal's name was Clapper. You are 100% right. This is the level where Clapper turns the water into ice. Oh, that was satisfying. Oh, my gosh. I love little barrel trails like that. You don't do anything and just blast off. You get a bunch of stuff. That's satisfying. They did that a lot more in DKC1 than in DKC2 or 3, but that's okay. One day, I'm looking forward to playing as Jungle Beat for the GameCube. It uses the bongos, but it is a platform, and it's a combo-based platformer. It's all about keeping off the ground and doing combinations in the air. It's really fun. It's really interesting. That'll be kind of annoying for you guys, I think, because you'll hear the clapping and stuff, so... It's gonna be a little odd, but I think it's gonna be a fun one. But yeah, no, I like this one a lot. Just the whole running on ice. I'm gonna risk that point. Running on ice and like, damn it, ducking under enemies while you're going and slipping around. I think it's fun. The fact that they have really good ice physics in this game is pretty neat. Bravo. Overall, a very impressive game, in my opinion. Oh no, how old? Dixie with her flutter jump thingy deal with this. So difficult. Wow, that was so easy. My goodness gracious me. Oh, we're doing it. We're doing good. Excuse me. Don't care about the N. Follow the bananas. They did a good job with the laying bananas around in this game. Because of the screen crunch, they're really like, look, we made this level. It doesn't fit on the Game Boy screen. We'll add some bananas. It helps the player know where to go. Plus, it's fun to collect bananas. The hit detection on the bananas is great. It's way better than collecting rings in the Sonic Game Gear games. Like, I like the Sonic Game Gear and Master System games, but it's very frustrating when you can't collect rings all that well. That's great. I don't need the G. Anyways, that is it for today. That was a lot of fun. With that, I'm Phil the Blanks. I'll see you next level. Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this episode, click that subscribe button and hit the bell icon to know when the next episode is up. If you want to support my channel, share some videos with some friends and consider supporting me on Patreon.